This real story is about none other than Jeff Bezos, one of the wealthiest men in the world. And in this video, we'll explain how he went from zero to billionaire status in a short time. Let's have Bezos himself tell us about his financial progress, and we'll comment throughout the video because we're confident it will add a lot of value to your financial life. This was the result I managed to achieve in March, just by creating automatic videos using artificial intelligence. Want to know how I do this? I can teach you. When you finish watching this video, click on the first link in the first pinned comment. In one of his interviews, Jeff said something like this: "I was working at a financial firm in New York City with a bunch of really smart people, and I had an amazing boss whom I greatly admired. I went to my boss and told him that I was going to start a big business, a small company that sells books on the internet. Let's pause for a comment. Did you notice something? Bezos had a great job that paid one of the highest salaries at that time. And you'll notice that he wasn't satisfied with it. He wanted to create his own business. A great job is all people want nowadays, but sometimes that's exactly what prevents people from growing. Think about it. If Bezos were content with his salary, he could have had an excellent salary for the rest of his life, but he would never be a billionaire. Do you know any billionaire employees? Because I don't. So I want to draw your attention to something very important. Dream big and don't rely solely on your salary. Dream big and fight for your goals, because you deserve much more than just a paycheck. Can I ask you something? Can you subscribe to this channel? It's very easy. Just click the subscribe button. Please do it, because we aim to reach 100,000 subscribers, and this will only be possible with your support. So I thank you. Thank you for subscribing." After Bezos told his boss about his project, it left him very impressed. So he took Jeff for a long walk in Central Park and listened to Bezos's entire plan. And after that, the boss replied, "That sounds like a really good idea, but it would be an even better idea for someone who didn't have a good job. You can have a job, or you can have a career, or you can have a calling. And if somehow you can figure out how to have a calling, you've hit the jackpot, because that's the big deal." Faced with this statement, what do you think Bezos chose? Of course, he chose to follow his dreams, but he had a great challenge ahead. Dave was a brilliant, ambitious guy, but he didn't really believe in Bezos's dreams. In an interview, he said something like this: "I met Jeff Bezos 25 years ago, and he told me, 'Dave, I want you to invest in my company. What are you doing?' 'I'm going to start a bookstore in my garage, and I'm going to start selling online. People buy online, and I'll ship from my garage. But if you invest in me, Dave, one day I'll be the richest man in the world. I'll make over $100 billion. I had no idea what he was talking about, and I highly doubted that it would be possible. First, there wasn't something called $100 billion 25 years ago. Statistically, that didn't exist. Countries didn't have $100 billion. Our national debt wasn't $100 billion. And this guy is telling me at 26 that he's going to be the richest man in the world because he has a garage and the internet. That was his truth. And no, he didn't know it, and neither did I. But the difference between him and me is that I was laughing and mocking him, and he was already patting himself on the back, following the right path at the right time, and believing that the plan he was devising would work. I'll make as much as I can as fast as I can, and I'm there thinking, there's no way this will become a big deal. I really didn't believe that Bezos could undertake something of this magnitude. Do something you're very passionate about, and don't try to follow what's sort of the passion of the moment." Seen from that perspective, it really was a tough choice, but in the end, I decided I had to try. I didn't think I would regret trying and failing, and I suspected I would always be haunted by a decision not to try. After much consideration, I opted for the less safe path to pursue my passion, and I'm proud of that choice. As a kid, I was a garage inventor. I invented an automatic gate closer made of tires filled with cement, a solar stove that didn't work very well made from an umbrella and aluminum foil, cooking pot alarms to catch my brothers. I always wanted to be an inventor, and I was determined to follow my passion. It's a military phrase that I especially love, and it says, "Slow is smooth, and smooth is fast. And I've seen that in every endeavor I've ever been in. That's the kind of thing that really allows you to make progress. Let's do a brief visualization exercise. Comment like this: I will become a millionaire by following my passions. Just comment this: I will become a millionaire by following my passions. When I see this comment, I'll give it a heart because I know you'll be a millionaire soon. Now that you've commented, let's continue. You know, you get certain gifts in life and you want to take advantage of those gifts. But I suppose my advice about adversity and success would be to take pride not in your gifts, but in your hard work and your choices. So, you wonder, what kinds of gifts have I received? For example, you may be very good at math. It may be very easy for you. That's a kind of gift. But practicing that math and taking it to the next level, that can be very challenging and difficult and require a lot of sweat. That's a choice. You can't really take pride in your gifts because they were given to you. You can be grateful for them and appreciative of them, but the choice is always yours. You choose to work hard. You choose to do difficult things. Those are choices you can be proud of. Instead of being proud of the gifts you received, be proud of the tough decisions you made. You can choose. We all can choose our life stories, and it's the choices that define us, not our gifts. Everyone watching this video has many gifts. I have many gifts. You can never take pride in your gifts because they're gifts. They were given to you. You may be tall, or you may be very good at math, or you may be extremely beautiful or handsome, so all of that are gifts. There are many gifts, and you can only be truly proud of your choices because they're the things that made you act. And one of the most important choices each of us has, and you know as well as I do, is that you can choose a life of ease and comfort, or you can choose a life of service and adventure. And when you're 80 years old, which of these things do you think you'll be prouder of? You'll be prouder of having chosen a life of service and adventure. There has never been a better time to be alive. It's just an incredible amount of inspiration that the world generates for me, and I think for many people. It's insane the amount of change and invention and opportunity. Your life, the life you write from scratch on your own, has already begun. How will you use your gifts? What choices will you make? Will inertia be your guide, or will you follow your passions? Will you follow dogma, or will you be original? Will you choose a life of ease or a life of service and adventure? Will you shrink from criticism, or will you follow your convictions? Will you blame someone else when you're wrong, or will you apologize? Will you protect your heart against rejection, or will you act when you're rebuffed? Will you want something safe, or will you be a little audacious? When it's hard, will you give up, or will you be relentless? Will you be a cynic, or will you be a builder? Will you be smart at the expense of others, or will you be self-taught? Every time you find a way to provide tools and services that empower others to develop their creativity, you really have something valuable to offer. You know, you're very lucky if you have a career. Many people spend their whole lives in a job. If you don't love what you do, you'll never be excellent at it. Jules Verne, Mark Twain, Galileo, Newton, all the curious of all time would have wanted to be alive now, more than anything. As a civilization, we'll have so many gifts, just like great people of the past. You who are watching this video also have many gifts. How are you using your gifts? And will you be proud of your gifts or your choices? Do you know why many people don't succeed in life? Because many abandon what starts, even before it succeeds. This shows the lack of consistency that most people have. Unlike you, who managed to watch this video to the end. This shows that you have persistence, so congratulations to you. Please let me know that you stayed until the end. Comment like this: I stayed until the end. When I see this comment, I'll know you're someone persistent. Do you find Bezos's story motivating? Do you know how you could achieve financial success too? But don't worry, you don't need to create the next Amazon. Just watch the video that's appearing on your screen right now. In this video, I'll explain to you better what you need to do. So click on it and go watch it. Do it now.